en la tormenta mi corazón no temerá. Cuando estoy desesperado, tu mano no me soltará. Cuando me encuentro sin aliento, yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien. Yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien. El mar valles, tú vas conmigo, tú eres fiel, porque yo sé, tú no me dejas, tú me rodeas, no temeré, cuando me encuentro sin aliento, yo sé que
este lugar, derramando tu amor. L'atmosfera cambiando sta. Tuo spirito sta.
Estamos muy emocionados porque hoy vamos a aprender que seguimos con el tema de determinación. Determinación, es decir, que vale la pena terminar lo que comenzaste. Hoy vamos a descubrir esto con nuestra gran idea. ¿Estás listo? Vamos a decirlo juntos. Dios te da lo que necesitas para seguir adelante. Muy bien. ¿Te ha sucedido alguna vez que como que necesitas algo para seguir adelante? Es decir, que estás haciendo un proyecto ahí en la casa y de repente te falta algo.
¡No tengo el papel rojo!
O quizás estás con tus amigos y quieren jugar un juego, pero
¡no trae pila!
O quizás tienes ganas de hornar algo muy rico ahí en tu casa, como unos cupcakes, cuando de repente te sucede que te falta algo.
¡No tengo huevos!
Pero ¿sabes qué? No importa qué es. Dios promete que Él siempre nos dará lo que necesitamos a su debido tiempo. Veremos esto en esta historia.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. And now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 41.
The room was crowded. Over 100 followers of Jesus gathered, sat on the floor, or knelt to pray. Peter, always quick to take charge, may have led them.
Lord, You told us to wait in Jerusalem. You promised to send Your Holy Spirit.
Now, just before, Jesus had gathered His closest friends at the Mount of Olives and instructed them to tell everyone about Him, from Jerusalem to every nation on earth. But then, right before their eyes, He had been taken up to heaven.
You've given us a huge job. We don't know how to do it when You're not here with us. So please, help us.
The room stilled as everyone waited, even though they weren't exactly sure what they were waiting for. James and John may have been near a window.
Getting windy out there. I'll just close the shutters.
I don't think that sound is outside.
Everyone, stay calm.
As the sound, like wind, rose even higher, a burst of light appeared in the center of the room. It flickered like a fireball, breaking into individual flames.
What on earth?
I don't think it's from Earth.
As the group watched, transfixed, the flames separated and skimmed out until a tongue of fire stood over the head of each believer in the room.
Is this?
It must be.
God's Holy Spirit.
As the Spirit of God filled the room and the heart of each believer, something even more incredible happened. Soon, the believers realized what was going on.
God has given us the power to speak other languages.
Immediately, the believers went out to join the crowds who had gathered in Jerusalem for the Feast of Pentecost. Now, these Jews traveled to Jerusalem from many regions and countries where a variety of languages were spoken, so they were shocked to hear the believers talking about Jesus in words they could understand, and each believer responded in their own language.
Aren't these people from Galilee?
Yes, so how do we hear them in our own native languages?
We've come from all over.
I've met people here from Parthia, Mesopotamia, Asia, Egypt, Libya.
But these Galileans are talking about God's wonders in our languages.
What does it mean?
I think it means they're a little loopy.
Loopy?
One fish short of a lunch, if you know what I mean.
Peter heard the doubters in the crowd, so he gathered the rest of the disciples and made his way up to the very front.
My fellow Jews, hey, people! Jesus of Nazareth was a man who had God's approval. God did miracles, wonders, and signs among you through Jesus. Long ago, God planned that Jesus would be handed over. You nailed him to the cross, but God raised him from the dead.
The crowd listened as the Holy Spirit gave Peter the words to say and helped them understand.
Jesus has received the Holy Spirit from the Father. This is what God had promised. It is Jesus who has poured out what you now see and hear. God has made him both Lord and Messiah.
Many people were deeply moved by the words Peter had spoken.
So what do we do now?
All of you must turn away from your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then your sins will be forgiven, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
I want to be baptized.
Me too.
Me three.
Then let's get started.
That day, 3,000 people believed in Jesus and were baptized. With the help of the Holy Spirit, Peter and the disciples were already beginning the big job of telling every nation on earth about Jesus, even before they left Jerusalem.
Recuerden nuestra gran idea. Vamos a decirlo juntos. Dios te da lo que necesitas para seguir adelante. Muy bien. No importa qué sea lo que tú necesites de tu casa. Recuerda que Dios siempre proveerá. Hasta la próxima, niños.
Adiós.